Hi folks, hope you're okay. We're looking at the history of Christianity by Dr. MacCulloch, and we're looking at origin. And on page 150 he writes, "Origin's importance was twofold as a biblical scholar and speculative theologian, in which roles he exhibited interestingly different talents. As a biblical scholar, he had no previous Christian rival. He set standards and directions for the giant task which was already occupying the church of redirecting the Tanakh to illuminating the significance of Jesus Christ and the divine plan, creating the text of the Bible as Christians know it. His biblical commentaries became foundational for later understanding of the origin of the Christian sacred text. Origen's biblical work showed a concern for exactness and faithfulness to received texts, something very necessary in an age when the text was still uncertain in many details." When the text was uncertain in many details, we'll get to that in a minute. MacCulloch's resume of origin is okay. I just want to say that I really love origin. I did an essay when I was at seminary many years ago on him, and I find him a fascinating character. He was a giant scholar. He was a man dedicated to God. He mixed Greek philosophy at times, and so he got himself into trouble because he philosophically meandered away from scripture sometimes. But he was a man who tried to expand the scriptures. He used an allegorical kind of method to strip away some of the literal meanings of the text, because maybe he didn't agree with inerrancy that like we believe in, some Christians, and MacCulloch picks up on that and denigrates those who believe in inerrancy and literalism. But that's a caricature of Christianity, because Christians use generally the historical grammatical method, which means that you take any piece of literature and use it that genre. So if it's poetry, you understand it as poetry. If it's history or a letter, you understand it from a history or letter. In other words, Dr. MacCulloch is kind of strawmanning what Christians believe about the Bible as if it's a wooden understanding, and trying to say that Origen was more ahead of his time than Christians today. But I would disagree, in the sense that a lot of these top academics in theology, history, whatever, will often strawman Christian position on what the Bible, what we believe is the Bible. We believe in the historical grammatical method, and that means using each piece of literature within the Bible in its own context. So if it's poetry, we expound it as poetry. If it's history, we expound it as history. That's a very flexible, nuanced approach that the modern scholars will not give or grant credit to Christianity or Christians today who believe in the authority and inspiration of the Bible. On the issue of origin, famous story where the literal interpretation about eunuchs won't, you know, you'll not enter the kingdom of heaven unless you're a eunuch. He had his water cut off so he could get into heaven, and he realized he took the scripture too literally. So you can understand why origin went for more of an allegorical interpretation of scripture. But the guy was a great scholar. He was an immense... one of the things that annoys me sometimes with modern textual critics is as if they're the first beginners of textual criticism. But, you know, people like Origen, they were the pioneers of textual criticism. If you read Bart Ehrman's book on textual criticism, it's as if textual criticism didn't start till the 1600s AD. But actually, there's been a long history of textual criticism going right back to the time of Origen. So, thumbs up for me for Origen. Okay, he wasn't as sound as he should have been, but his contribution to commentaries, his contribution to biblical Christianity and passing on Christianity was immense, and we owe him a great debt. All right. Thank you for listening, and take care.